destroying the stronghold of fear unto victory. Destroying the stronghold of fear unto victory.
Amen.
Fear is one of the weapons of the enemy, especially the devil, that he uses against even the children of God. And I want to admonish you today that never allow fear to incapacitate you. In the book of Judges chapter 7, 2 and 3, Judges 7, 2 and 3, you read the account of God's people trying to go to the battle. But there were about 32,000. And God told Gideon, this number is too much for me, because by the time they have the victory, they will say it's because they are so number. Let me reduce them for you. I told them, he told Gideon to tell them, is there anybody afraid among you? Let him go back. I'm sure Gideon must have been thinking nobody will go back now, because all of us have been practicing and everybody has gone and everything. And for them to have even enrolled, that means that they already knew what they were in for. But it was shocked that 22,000 went back. Wow. And the Lord said unto Gideon, the people that are with thee are too many for me to give the Midianites into their hands, lest Israel vaunt themselves saying against me, saying, my own hand has saved me. Now therefore go to proclaim in the ears of the people, saying, whosoever is fearful and afraid, let him return and depart early from Mount Gilead. And there returned of the people, how many? 22,000. And there remained 10,000. And when you go further, you see that it now remained 300. That was enough to even make Gideon himself to be afraid, which he was actually afraid after a while. That is the tactic of the devil, to make you afraid. How could they be going to war and they are afraid? How could you be praying, fasting, and you are still afraid that God might not do that thing? You may be looking at them as with your own physical eye, but we are fighting spiritual warfare. Meaning that it's possible for some people to be asking God for something that they are not even believing. Just like some people gathered themselves, they were praying once upon a time for Peter to be released. By the time the answer even came to their door, they were calling the girl mad. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every spirit of fear that is cohabiting with me, flush out of my life in the name of Jesus. Flush out every spirit of fear that has been cohabiting with me, out of my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. When you read the scripture anywhere, you see that the first introduction or the first mention of fear or being afraid happened to be in Genesis 3, 10 and 11. Genesis 3, 10, 11. There God came to Adam and called him, Adam, where art thou? He said, I heard thy voice and I was afraid and hid myself. Then God told him, who told you that you were naked? Let me read it. And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden and I was afraid. The first mention of fear in the Bible. Because I was naked and I hid myself. And he said, who told thee that thou was naked? Art thou eating of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat? Who told thee? The first source that we are being pointed to that brings fear is the words from the devil or the agent of the devil or the people devil is inspiring that are not really the agent of the devil. Words from the devil, words from the agent of the devil, words from our own people, but devil is inspiring them to speak some words to us. Be careful of the words you allow to enter into your hearts.
He said, who
told you? Meaning, what have you been listening to? You have been listening to people that have been saying, this thing is hard, and that fear will not start gripping you. Are you sure you can actually do this thing? And I'm putting it to you, just like God put it to Adam today. Who told you that you cannot make it? Who told you you cannot get that job? Who told you you cannot settle down and be married with a good family? Who told you you cannot have the children? Who told you you cannot get the accommodation? Who told you you cannot get that job? Who told you you cannot travel? Regardless of what you are saying, those ones, they are null and void. They are not relevant. Devil is a liar. And Jesus Christ was telling the disciple about this truth about the devil. There's a truth about the devil. That truth is that he's a liar and the father of all lies. In the book of John chapter 8, 44, John 8, 44, Jesus Christ was telling his disciple in this portion of this Bible, ye have your father, the devil, and the love of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in what? In the truth. Because there is what? No truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own. For he is what? A liar and the father of it. See that kind of title that Jesus Christ gave him. Said that he's a liar. So whatever is contrary to what God has told you is what? Is a liar. If they are saying, telling you that because you did not go to school, you will not make it, it is what? Yeah. A lie. If they are saying that because your womb has been, something has happened when you were a teenager and you will not have a child, it's what? Yeah. It's a lie. In the book of Romans chapter 3, 3 and 4, Romans chapter 3, one of my favorite scripture in the Bible, Romans 3, 3 and 4, even when people don't believe what God has said concerning you, that is their own business. You choose to believe it. For what if some did not believe? Shall their unbelief make the faith of God without effect? God forbid. Verse 4. God forbid. Yeah, let God be what? Be true. But every man a liar. Everything that God has not said is a lie. Anything that you are seeing, the Bible says that we should not look at the things that we are seeing because they are temporal, but because the things that cannot be seen that God has already said, they are the real one which will come to pass. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, I thank you for your word to me. Therefore, every lie that has been dominating my heart disappear in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for your word towards me. Therefore, every lie that has been dominating my heart disappear. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Refuse to listen to the words of the devil, the words of doubt, or the words from the agents of the devil, or the words from good people but being inspired by the devil to lie to you. The reason why King Saul and his men, the soldiers, could not face Goliath happened to be the word that was coming from Goliath. Said, I will destroy people. I will, and they were afraid. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17:11, 1 Samuel 17:11, the Bible said that when Saul and all Israel, what did they do? They heard those words of the Philistine Goliath. They were dismayed and greatly afraid. But David refused to be afraid. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17:32. 1 Samuel 17:32. He was telling King Saul, don't worry. The people that were having sword, they were afraid. The one that was with doubt is not about what you have or what you don't have. It's about the word of God that is seated in your heart. And David said to Saul, was saying to the people that have the weapon, let no man's heart fail because of him. Thy servant will go and fight with this Philistine. Because people that size up themselves with their problem, they easily get intimidated and overwhelmed. But size up your problem with God, and your problem will lose its power. That's what they read in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17, 46. 1 Samuel 17, 46. He said that this day, the Lord, not me, will deliver you into my hand. Don't always think that it's not about you, but it's about the God that you serve. This day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand, and I will smite thee and take thy head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day to the fowl of the air and to the wild beasts of the earth, and all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. Refuse to fear. Tell your neighbor, refuse to fear. Refusing to fear means that it is a choice not to fear. It's not that fear will not come. You know one thing about this insight that I've given between Mike Tyson and Mike Spinks in 1988, I think June 27, 1988, when they had a boxing bout. And that boxing bout was, in fact, one of the money engulfing boxing bout. I think Mike Tyson went home with $20 million from that singular bout. And of course, the one that lost, Mike Spinks, $13.5 million. But you know something, at the end of the day, Mike Spinks confessed and said, immediately he confronted him, fear gripped him. And both of them have not been defeated. They were both champions, but they just that they have not made. But the way though Mike Tyson has been defeating people very, very early, you know, fear had gripped him. And Mike Tyson also said, when I gave him the first blow, I saw the way he wobbled. I knew I've gotten this one. Don't allow the devil to get you down. Fear is an instrument that he uses. There was a particular brother that went for an interview. When he go for an interview, he had already received the message. But the day before the interview, he had a dream. Not every dream is, sometimes the devil will bring something so that you'll be like, get up and cancel it and release the bomb of God into the camp of the enemy. So that they will know that they will not be trying you anyhow. Is there anything you will be afraid? And the brother prayed, when he got to the place, actually they said that they did not see his name on the computer. To come down to the church, he went outside, he prayed, he commanded the computer to vomit his name. Yes. By the time they saw him there, they said, ah, where are you? See, your name has already come out. And he was enlisted among the four people that they will interview. To call the Lord's nature, he had a dream overnight again that the people did not favor him in that panel. He prayed, and truly, by the time he got to the place, he saw the way they came in, those panel people, judges, came in into the room in that particular dream, was the way they were coming in. He just went to one corner and he just said, I reverse every negative dream that I've been used to prophesy failure into my life. You know that those people that antagonized him in his dream were the ones that favored him most. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, I refuse to be afraid, because I will get everything that you have destined for me in life. In the name of Jesus, I refuse to be afraid. I will get everything that you are destined for me in life. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Stop looking at the things that you are seeing. They can make you to be afraid. The Bible said that when Peter saw the wind boisterous, he began to sing. Believe what God has said over what God you are seeing. The just shall live by faith, not by sight. You know something about Mary? How Mary got the miracle that she got, the miracle of Jesus Christ. In the book of Luke chapter 1 verse 34, initially she was looking at the natural situation when the angel delivered the message. She said that, how will this thing be? Seeing is eyes, five senses can put people into stagnation. Then said we unto the angel, how shall this be, seeing I know not a man? Can you give me verse 38? Verse 38. And Mary said, behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to what?
Thy word.
And the angel departed. At that point in time, she conceived. That was the point at which the seed of God entered into her. The point of you receiving the word of God, that's the point of you getting the seed that will now grow unto manifestation. I prophesy into your life that everything that God has promised you, that fear has been keeping away from you, you shall receive.
Amen.
I said you shall receive.
Amen.
Also, have you been afraid before? Many times. Courage is not the absence of fear. It's going ahead to do what God has told you to do, regardless of the fear. It's not that fear. That's why most of the time, when the angel will just come, they will just force it. Fear not. Fear not. It's not that fear will not come, but that's why I said that fear is a choice. But you can also choose not to be afraid. That's why David was saying that even though I walk through Psalm 23 by verse 4, through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear. No. Yes, though I walk through the valley, he was walking through physically, valley of the shadow of death. I will in the little English that I know is a decision. I will fear no evil. Say to yourself, I will fear no evil.
I
will get all God has planned for me to get. How do you get this done? Number one, confess your unconfessed sin unto God. I discovered that Adam was not afraid initially. Anytime God came, he will come. But this particular time, what made him to go and hide? He had done something wrong. Sin has a way of allowing fear to come into you. But the way to deal with sin is to confess and forsake sin. And you will see that fear will lose its stronghold upon your life. Then number two, you need to put yourself in the atmosphere that you listen to other people's testimony. You know how Mary was able to receive her own miracle? The angel told her, said that your cousin that was called barren, she is now with a child, so mourn. The next verse, Mary that said, hey, be it unto me. Meaning that the testimony of others is not for you to be jealous about. That is a wrong approach. But for you to know that God that did this for this person, we do my own. And that is what will happen in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then the number point three is continually feed yourself with the word of God. Faith comes by what? Hearing and hearing and hearing. They did not say faith comes by having heard. Don't say that I came to church yesterday. By hearing, the reason why men of God keep on moving is because they put themselves in the position, or they have a job that they keep on hearing, they keep on speaking. Even when they are speaking, they are hearing themselves, and it increases their faith. Even when you are not a preacher, put yourself in the atmosphere that you keep on hearing. Then the last point, choose not to fear. It's a choice. And God will help us in Jesus' name. Let us have faith and say, Father, I thank you for your word that has come to me today. Thank you for your word that has come to me today. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, every stronghold of fear in my life, shatter in the name of Jesus. Shatter. Let every stronghold of fear in my life be shattered into pieces. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, surround me with situations and things that will increase my faith, and I will possess my possession in the name of Jesus. Surround me with situations, things, people that will increase my faith and to get my possession. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. Dear my last Father, we thank you for the word that has come to us, that we should destroy the stronghold of fear in our life to get our victory. Let this be unto us in the name of Jesus. As we are going out of this place with faith, knowing that the devil is a liar, let everything that has been elusive unto us. Good things, let them start coming unto us. Before the end of today, let us have so many testimonies. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let somebody that received that shout hallelujah.